Like, comment, share and subscribe.
Theresa May has warned Donald Trump that his unjustified steel tariffs risk putting America's security alliance with the UK at risk. Speaking out about the looming threat of a tit-for-tat trade war, the Prime Minister called for Britain and the rest of the EU to be excluded from the swinging 25% levy because of the vital role the steel industry played in the defence of the West. Her intervention followed confirmation from Brussels that the EU will retaliate against the charges on exports to the US activated yesterday. The bloc accused the US president of playing a dangerous game with his lurch towards protectionism and signaled that Levi's jeans, Harley-Davidson motorcycles, Jack Daniel's bourbon whiskey, cranberries, and peanut butter were among the US exports in line for punitive charges. Mr. Trump's administration announced earlier this week that a 25% tariff on steel and 10% on aluminium were being imposed on imports from the EU, Mexico, and Canada. In a statement released by Downing Street last night, Mrs. May said, "I am deeply disappointed at the unjustified decision by the US to apply tariffs to EU steel and aluminium imports. The US, EU and UK are close allies and have always promoted values of open and fair trade across the world." In a diplomatic warning, she took the unusual step of raising the UK-US security alliance, the bedrock of the so-called special relationship between the two allies, in her statement. "Our steel and aluminium industries are hugely important to the UK, but they also contribute to US industry, including in defence projects which bolster US national security," the Prime Minister said. "The EU and UK should be permanently exempted from tariffs and we will continue to work together to protect and safeguard our workers and industries." Mrs. May spoke out shortly after a senior Eurocrat confirmed that the EU had opened a case against the US with the World Trade Organization in Geneva. EU Trade Commissioner Cecilia Malmström, speaking at a news conference in Brussels, said, "We are not in a trade war, but we are in a very difficult situation caused by the United States. I would not use the term trade war because it has a psychological effect." But she added, "The US is playing dangerous game here." Ms. Malmström said a final decision on what products would be hit with tariffs had yet to be made. She added that the targeted goods would come from a 10-page list previously published by the EU, which included motorcycles, jeans, bourbon, cranberries and peanut butter. "We are not seeking to escalate any situation, but we need to respond and will do so in a measured manner, but not responding would be the same as accepting these tariffs which we consider are illegal," the trade commissioner said. She admitted the dispute created a very worrying situation. "It could escalate, and also the economic recovery that we have seen lately, notably in the European Union but globally, risks to be diminished by this," she added. The director of trade body UK Steel, Gareth Stace, said he was very, very worried about the potential impact of a double whammy on British steel producers. He feared the UK industry could be shut out of an American market that bought around £350 million worth of British steel last year. Britain could also be swamped by a tsunami of cheap steel from other countries facing US tariffs. Mr. Stace told BBC Radio 4's World at One that it was too early to speculate on the likely impact on jobs. "At worst, we could fall straight back into the crisis we suffered in 2015-16, which was the worst steel crisis in a generation," he said. "We are heading for a trade war, which is going to be all losers, there will be no winners. The US economy will suffer as much as any other economy." Mr. Stace said the EU should activate safeguard measures to prevent European markets being disrupted by a surge of as much as 25 million tons of steel diverted from the US. International Trade Secretary Liam Fox yesterday insisted the US steel tariffs were of dubious legality. In a television interview, he said, "We are 100% behind the EU in taking this dispute to the World Trade Organization, which is the proper place to take it up if you believe in a rules-based system. It is very unfortunate if we get into this tit-for-tat position, especially with one of our closest allies. Nobody wins in a trade war, there are only casualties." In a separate statement released by his Whitehall department, the Tory cabinet minister said, "I have been very clear these tariffs are not justified. We have not ruled out countermeasures and will support any EU appeal to the World Trade Organization. He added, we do not want a trade war which does more to harm UK industries and consumers. President Trump announced swingeing tariffs on steel imports from around the world last March. He granted a temporary exemption for the EU, Mexico, and Canada pending further negotiations. But the exemptions expired early yesterday and were allowed to come into force. The Canadian and Mexican governments also expressed fury about the move yesterday. Canada, the largest supplier of steel to the US, slapped tariffs worth around £10 million on American imports including whiskey, orange juice, steel, and aluminium. Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau said, "The American administration has made a decision today that we deplore, and obviously is going to lead to retaliatory measures, as it must." Mr. Trump hit back on Twitter, saying, Canada has treated our agricultural business and farmers very poorly for a very long period of time. Highly restrictive on trade. They must open their markets and take down their trade barriers. They report a really high surplus on trade with us. Do timber and lumber in US. Mexico also announced new tariffs on US imports including pork, apples, grapes, cheese, and steel. French President Emmanuel Macron telephoned the White House to warn Mr. Trump that he thought the tariffs were mistaken and illegal. A spokesman for the World Trade Organization, WTO, said, the WTO Secretariat has received the EU request for dispute settlement consultations on the US Section 232 measures. Former White House Press Secretary Anthony Scaramucci, a friend of the US President, yesterday insisted there was always room for negotiation with Mr. Trump. I am sure that there are chips on both sides that can get traded to make the problem go away, Mr. Scaramucci said.